Greetings and welcome to this week's Prime Insight. My name is Gavin Gooden. I'm the Marketing Director here at BlastOne. Today we want to discuss a very common scenario is where people are blasting inside shipping containers. And what often happens when you're blasting inside a shipping container, it gets very dusty because you don't have good, adequate ventilation. You don't have good lighting, and you don't have a good way to get the airflow coming through that container because it's a sealed 8 foot by 8 foot by 20 foot container. So what I want to cover today is a couple of principles on how to effectively ventilate, light, and make an effective workspace inside of a container. The first thing is when you're drawing air through a shipping container is to actually ventilate the air out of the back of the container. So bring the air in through the doors and out of the back. To do that, attach the vent to the top and the back of the shipping container. And in front of that, you actually want to place a plenum wall. So from the top down to about 18 inches above the floor, you want to have a fixed wall, which is about 12 inches from the back of the container. Effectively, what happens then is the air will come in from the front of the shipping container, through past the blaster, and underneath this wall, and out the back of the container. While you have the baffle there, any abrasive particles will fall out when they turn to go up towards the outlet. Then if you actually place an angle to the floor, any abrasive that does fall out will fall back into an easy area for you to collect and dispose of. The next point we want to discuss is how to light it. We'd always recommend using sealed lighting, which is explosion proof. Doesn't have to be explosion proof for a blasting area, but it is recommended. I'd mount four of them in a 20 foot container along the top runs. So if you put them throughout the container, pointing down on a diagonal towards the center of the container, you have very effective lighting and the blast will be able to see what they're doing. What you want to avoid is doing a blasting job in a dingy environment, taking it outside to take it back to the job, and we missed a spot. And you have to put it back in the container. That's often manual handling. Material handling is often the most costly part of a project. And the final point we cover is protecting other people around the environment, making sure abrasive doesn't come out of the container. And we simply recommend that you use a screen door, like what you'd have on a chicken shed. So you have like just a wooden, simple frame door with some chicken mesh in it, and then cover that with some mesh just to stop abrasive particles from coming out. Air can easily flow through it, but abrasive particles won't come out. And that'll give you an effective, highly lit, well-ventilated shipping container to do a good job. We sell blast booths and paint booths, supporting contractors all over the world, especially here in America, in Australia, New Zealand, Malaysia. We're here to help. Got any technical questions, how to streamline your system, put a new blast booth in, we're here to help you. Don't hesitate to reach out. Thank you for watching this week's Prime Insight. We'll see you next week.